Greetings, Walter Zygarewicz here with Global Vision Ministries, and I am joined by missionary evangelist Tony F. Abram. Welcome to Prayer for America and the Nations. Thank you for joining us in the United States, Canada, Mexico, and Asia, Africa, Europe, wherever you are joining us from. Welcome. And it is going to be a power-packed half hour. So quickly take a moment and press share on your profile, Facebook profile, so that your friends, your family, your loved ones can join you in this power-packed half hour of prayer and testimony. Brother Tony, would you greet the people?
I'd like to greet everyone in the name of Jesus, and I'd like to just share this. It just came from Kenneth Medder, Dr. Kenneth Medders, friend of ours for over 50 years. Listen to this. Difficulties come our way. We can run or we can stay. That's when we can put our faith in God and commit everything into His hands. Difficulties may be challenges. Problems may be opportunities. Perhaps they're sent, simply sent to us so we can respond correctly. I believe God can work out things in our lives where all things work together for good to those who love God and are called according to our called to the purpose of God. And Walter, I believe that what we're doing here today is called by God to do, and we are doing it.
Amen, amen to that. I believe that. And you know, we are continuing to pray for people around the world. And Brother Tony, there are not only prayer requests, but there are testimonies. We had prayed a while back on different occasions for Sister Sheila in Kenya, one of our Bible school graduates there in that nation, and she recently got married. We had prayed for her and her husband, and everything went well with their wedding. Her husband got a job, which was one of her prayer requests, but she still is asking for prayer now that she would get a good job where she could still continue to minister and do the work of the Lord. So that and for the health of her husband, they've just gotten married. So we're going to believe for that. And we thank God for the answer already. We're praying for Brother Peter in Kenya, who lost everything as far as his business that he had due to the lockdowns of the pandemic. And he has a large family, plus he had taken in his sister's children who had, his sister had passed away from, I believe it was AIDS or something, and left a family of children whom he took in as his own. So he is out there trying to make things happen. And Brother Peter, we are praying for you. God is on the throne. God loves you, and there is no distance in prayer. And we have been praying for various people around the world. We have been praying for pastors in Nepal who had been suffering from the virus. And Brother Tony, two of the pastors are still in the hospital, but they are much better, and we are believing for their soon release. We are praying for others who have been affected by the virus, not only in Nepal, but in places like Bolivia, where several pastors had passed away, and there are several that have been badly affected. We just found some of this news recently, but we are praying for them, and we are praying for all who have been affected. Whether or not you are a pastor is not the point. We are praying for all who are in need of prayer around the world. So do send us your prayer requests. We will try to include them, if not in the broadcast, then after or before the broadcast, we will be praying for your needs. And if you've sent a prayer request, you can be assured that if we've seen it, we prayed for it, and we stand in faith with you. Brother Tony, I know that you have a testimony you want to share, but I just want to encourage people with this scripture in Romans 8:11. It says, but if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit who dwells in you. So we as believers have the spirit of God living in us, and it is the spirit of God that resurrected Jesus from the dead. Can you imagine that that same Holy Spirit is living in you if you are a believer in Jesus Christ? And that same Holy Spirit will give power, will give health, will give strength to your mortal body. Hallelujah. Well, we are believing for healings. And Brother Tony, you have ministered in over 125 nations. I would call your type of ministry power evangelism. The reason I say that is because it has been with the accompanying gifts, power gifts of the Holy Spirit, signs, wonders, healings, casting out of demons, deliverances. And I have seen this with my own personal eyes because I was there translating for you in a number of those meetings. And the ones I didn't translate, well, I was there. I had was working with you. And of course, I've seen that in other ministries as well, but I was very impacted by that. Would you share? I know you had a testimony there, but share what the Lord has put in your heart.
Well, first of all, I want to say that for the people who do not know it, that you also have this ministry because you have gone to the nations. Now you're praying for the nations, and God has used you in a marvelous way and is continuing to do so. And what I wanted to share with you is it's kind of appropriate that I use something that Dr. Menners has just put on Facebook for all to read. He was with us when we were together, you and Marge, myself, and also Dr. Ken Menners. We were in Brazil. He spent that time, I think, better than 6 weeks with us. And we had great crusades across the country of Brazil. One thing I can say about Brazil, if big crowds with thousands of people being saved, hundreds and hundreds of miracles of healing, and many other miracles happening is you could call success, then we have had nothing but success in the ministry in Brazil, because what marvelous crowds, some of the smaller cities, half the cities would come out to the crusade. But I'm thinking of one particular, when we were in the city of Criciúma, there in, what was the name of that state? Santa Catarina or something like that?
Yeah, yes.
Yes, it's one. Well, anyways, we were there, and the grounds that we got was the former train station. And it had a wonderful big platform, and they had not taken the tracks out and so forth. But across maybe a quarter mile away, we could see the Ferris wheel of a great a carnival or a circus that had come to the city at the same time. And what was marvelous, the crowds began to grow, and more people were coming to the crusade, so much that during the crusade time, they literally closed the circus, and all the circus people even came to the crusade. Well, God was doing so many wonders, and also Dr. Metters had filmed almost all of what had taken place. But there was one woman. Now, the Bible tells us, and you've repeated this a number of times, God creates the fruit of our lips. Our confession is so important. And it is also noted that when we confess God's word, it has creative power. And we've seen creative miracles take place. The Bible says that Jesus healed the maimed and the halt. That's actually people with parts of the body missing. But there was one particular woman who came to Christ who had a kidney removed, and the other kidney was going bad. Well, she received the Lord, and one night during the prayer of faith, when people were being healed all over the grounds, this woman said, when she testified, that she felt like there was a balloon blowing up in her back. Well, when she came on the platform, of course, like we tell people, go and see your doctor, let him verify the miracle or the healing. And she went back, and to her even surprise, but she was praising the Lord for it because she was confessing it, they said to her, "Madam, we don't understand. We had removed one of your kidneys, but now you have another kidney in its place." And they says, "Well, what must have happened? You must have had a third kidney in your body, and it finally fell down in place. And she's and the other kidney is now working also perfectly. It must have happened like that." And she said, "No, doctor, it didn't happen like that. God created a new kidney." And so, friends, I want to say to you that nothing is impossible with God. We are serving a God. I remember when I worked for T.L. Osborne, this is going many years ago before I was married and before I had ever met Brother Walter. I was his associate evangelist. And maybe it's a little bit of pride, but I was proud to say that I was his number one associate evangelist. And God used me in a particular way. And he taught that there was power in the Word of God. There was creative power in God's Word. And so we believe and are believing God to do the supernatural. I believe that in the last days before Jesus returns, we're going to see greater and more marvelous testimonies. The unlimited God, Osborne preached, and our God is unlimited. And today, if you will look to the Lord, all things are possible. Brother Walter, I believe God's going to do some good things here in this broadcast. God bless you, my brother.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for sharing that. And that was one of many testimonies. I recall that in that city, during that event, it shook that city and that region so much. The mayor of the city was impacted and invited us to dinner in his home. Thankful for what God was doing in that city, because he saw the drunkards' lives being changed. Those that were bums on the streets, their lives being changed, thievery coming down, things that, you know, people that were, whose lives were radically changed, and where these alcoholics were just maybe laying on the street, now were up on their feet with a smile and a changed heart. Well, it was quite impacting, and I recall spending some time in preparation there in that city prior to your coming, and that is where I started picking up the Portuguese language in a serious way with the Lord's miraculous help. So many memories from the city of Criciúma in Santa Catarina, southern Brazil. But it was, I believe, on that tour with Brother Ken Manners and yourself that we also visited a city in the north of Brazil called Ouro Preto, which means black gold. And this was during the time when there was a movie in America that was making headlines everywhere around the world called The Exorcist. And they heard about you casting out demons, and they put big headlines in the newspaper, "The Exorcist is coming." Boy, did we have a lot of people in that crusade. Well, we were definitely casting out demons in Brazil as elsewhere in the world. But do you recall that, Brother Tony?
Yes, and also back in the Criciúma, if you remember, that at that time there was a lot in the news of the killer bees that even come to the United States. And the one day, a swarm of them had come, and they were hanging there by the where we were having the crusade, by the platform, right above the platform. And I know that a lot of people thought, well, if we sing or make any noise, it's going to set them wild. They're going to go killing people. But doing the crusade service, not one bee left that hive or that swarm. And they were just sitting there. And I got to thinking, well, even the killer bees are being converted during this crusade. And the next day, the firemen came out, and they destroyed that hive or that swarm that was sitting there. So God, the devil tried to stop that crusade even that night. But God, if God be for us, who then can be against us? Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Brother Tony, today churches think that to be successful, the pastor's got to wear skinny jeans. They've got to have big screens and smoke machines.
Yes.
But I believe that what churches need is the power of God.
Amen.
You can have the most eloquent message. You can have the best sound equipment. You can have the most beautiful screen that was ever made. But if the power of God is not there, you've got the most important ingredient missing, the presence of God. And today, more than ever, people are hungry for God, for the manifestation of the power of God. And I'm not against having nice big screens or good sound equipment. Some of the sound equipment we've used overseas, we had to pray it through the service. I remember one time that little amplifier in one of the cities in Brazil, I don't know if it was smoke or steam coming out of it because it was very hot and steamy, but we made it through and it did not burn out. So I can appreciate good sound equipment. I'm not against that. The point is we're putting the emphasis in the wrong place. People need the reality of God. They need to experience God. You can have a beautiful program. You can have many things in your service. You can have an eloquent message, but the power of God is what people need today. If you can be eloquent and have the power of God, all the best to you. But Brother Tony, that's why we're doing these broadcasts, not to compete with anybody, not to try to pull away from what churches are doing. We're trying to encourage people to go to churches, but we also need to encourage churches to go back to the basics, to remember where they started, and to not forget and not to be ashamed of praying in the Spirit, not be ashamed of allowing the Holy Spirit to move in the services and encouraging the manifestation of the power of God freely in services. Would you not agree?
Yes, I agree 100%. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Malachi 3:6, God says, I am the Lord, I change not. And if he was a miracle worker in Bible days, he still remains a miracle worker today. If he is unchanging, his love is unchanging, his power is unchanging. And what he did in yesterday year in the scriptures, he can do today. But we've got to confess and believe it. And it all comes with that positive confession that God is the same and that he loves us. And I know there is a move in the world by the Antichrist. Just across the border, I'm listening today, there in Calgary. Here another pastor is hauled off to jail for the rest of the month. He's locked up in the prison. Why? Because he wanted to meet outside with his congregation and praise the Lord and love God and serve the Lord together as a congregation praying. And they don't let that. Yet the hockey teams, all the other stuff, the stampede or the rodeo is continuing on. But we can't have church. Why? It's the devil. He fears when God's people get together, even with what you're doing here with these broadcasts and asking people to share. The devil hates that. There are a number of people that are even speaking against these broadcasts. What is it? Well, it's the lies of the devil. They're lying, saying negative things, things that are not true. And yet Christians aren't doing anything about it. The biggest thing you can do is share this. If you want the gospel to go out with signs and wonders following, if you want people to be healed, you want people to be saved by the grace of God, I think you need to share this. God doesn't have you just watching this, but he wants you to share it with others. Of course, if you don't believe what we're saying, I guess I can't ask you to share. But if you love God, if you want people to be saved, if you want people to be helped, then I encourage you to share these broadcasts with others. It is an arm. It is a means. And on that day, the Lord's going to say, what did you do with the opportunities I gave you? This is an opportunity to share the gospel, because if you do, others will hear and others can have the opportunity of being blessed, being saved, being healed, being delivered. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you, Brother Walter.
Amen. And we are in a spiritual battle right now. And that is why we are praying for America. We do not want that to happen, which you just described as happening in Canada and in parts of America. Similar things have been going on, but thankfully things have been repelled, things have been pushed back, and churches need to be open. People need to hear the gospel. People need encouragement as never before. And that little program is not going to cut it. You need the power of God. We are engaged in spiritual battle. When we have these evangelistic crusades all over the world, it wasn't just going up there and it's all easy. No, we were constantly in a spiritual battle, binding the forces of the devil over that city, over that nation, over that region, and then proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ, the gospel of liberty. And it is the power of God, the power of the gospel of Jesus Christ, that touched those people's lives, and the Holy Spirit transformed their lives. And I tell you, we saw many, many demon-possessed delivered. And Brother Tony, maybe on the next broadcast, we could even talk about that. Our time is running here. We want to pray, and we have prayer requests that we are praying for. There are People with suffering with cancer. There are people suffering from the virus or the after effects of the virus, not only physically, many physically, but some also emotionally. There are many people who have been scarred emotionally with the lockdowns. We are praying for people who have lost their business, their job, their finances, because of all those lockdowns, because of the pandemic. We're praying for those people. And we're praying for those who are just facing life challenges. Life did not stop because of the pandemic and lockdowns. People have issues. People have needs. And so we are praying for Vera and your family. We're praying for Svetlana, who wants God to touch her in her spirit, soul, mind, and body. Praise God. That's what we should invite Jesus to be in control of our entire life. We're coming against depression that has affected some people, the spirit of fear that has gripped some people. We're coming against that. And we're praying for healing for Rachel and her knee, that it would heal up rapidly and properly. But there's Olya with diagnosed with breast cancer. Amber, only 15 years old, bone cancer. There is a Pastor Milan Roca's mom in Nepal, diagnosed with lung cancer. So we are praying for these. And you may not be on this list, but that does not matter. You who are at the sound of our voice right now, believe and receive. So Father, the name that is above every name, I curse that cancer. We agree with Brother Tony and with those that are in prayer and agreement with us. We curse that cancer. We command every trace of that cancer to die in your body and come out of your body. And I pray, oh God, that every cell that is damaged would be healed in the name of Jesus Christ and replaced by a healthy cell. We command every cancerous cell to leave the body and new cells to be formed. And I pray that those lungs would be healed. And this is around Roca's mom. And Lord, we speak healing to that young girl, 15 years old. Touch her, Lord God, we pray. Save her and deliver her in Jesus' name. We pray for Sister Olya in Seattle in the name of Jesus, that you would heal her of that breast cancer condition. Lord God, we pray for Vera and her family. You know their needs, spiritual, physical, financial. Meet those needs, we pray in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for Sister Svetlana, who wants your intervention in every area of her life. Bless her, strengthen her, fill her with your power. And Lord God, we thank you that you are a healing, that you've touched Brother Tony, who's so much better now. We thank you for that. We thank you that you're healing Brother Dean and his wife Doris. We thank you for Sister Sheila, how that you have answered a prayer with regards to her husband getting a job and everything going well with the wedding, providing for that. But Lord, she is also asking for a prayer for her husband's health. Heal him, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, provide a good job for Sister Sheila, that she would have the time for ministry, which is where her heart is burning to minister unto you. And Lord God, we just thank you for answering prayer. Brother Tony, as the Lord leads you, there are people with fear, with depression, other needs. Would you just lead out and pray as the Lord leads you?
And Father, we agree with Walter in the name of Jesus. You said it too, upon earth, agree upon touching anything, it would be given them of our Father, which is in heaven. And Lord, we bring the people that are in need. Lord, you see the suffering folks, Lord, that are watching and listening to this broadcast. And we send the word of healing. Lord, just reach out and touch each one as they look to you for help, for healing, for deliverance. You see the homes, you see the broken homes, you see the prayer requests for that unsaved husband, for that unsaved wife, for those children, Lord, that are mixed with drugs. My God, deliver them. For that husband that who is an alcoholic, deliver him. Lord, we curse those cancers in the name of Jesus. Let the very healing virtue of Christ flow into every man, every woman, every child. You see that baby that the doctor says doesn't have long to live. My Lord, we send the word, Lord. It doesn't matter what that ailment is, that little heart, Lord, heal in the name of Jesus. Lord, touch each one. And Lord, move upon the hearts of your people that will watch this, Lord, that they will share it, Lord, that others may be touched, that others might be saved and healed. Lord, you see that alcoholic, oh Lord, as we pray for the one, we see there are many, Lord, alcoholics that are trying to serve you, but they keep falling back into the clutches of that damnable alcohol that is literally twisting their lives and ruining their families. Those drug addictions, Lord, we break them in the name of Jesus. And now, Lord, visit those hospitals. Visit those hospital rooms where loved ones are sick and so many are dying. But, Lord, if it's not their time to go, Lord, reach forth and touch them and deliver them. Send some member of the family to lay hands on them that can pray the prayer of faith and agreement and appoint them to the living Savior. Oh God, you are able to do that exceedingly abundantly. And Lord, we see coming over Facebook and over email and over the phone and via text, Lord, all these requests, they're too numerous to name each one by one. But Lord, we take them like in a basket of faith and we raise them up to you, Lord. We lift them up to you. Let your healing virtue flow. But most of all, Lord, in that basket of requests, there is the need for people to be saved by the grace of God. Lord, break the habits of chains and set people free. Set that mother free. Set that daughter free. Set that son free. Set that father free in the name of Jesus, that they may call upon the name of the Lord and not only be saved, but be delivered from that anger, be delivered from that fear, delivered from that demonic obsession and oppression in the name of Jesus. Let your healing virtue come and deliver. We speak to you, demonic powers. Your powers are broken in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ be against you. We speak the word. We speak the power of the blood of Jesus. We speak, Lord, the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord, against all those bondages. And we loosen the people, Lord, break every chain, the chain of sickness, the chain of sin. Lord, break them in Jesus' name and set your people free. Lord, everyone that's watching, you love them. You died for them. You rose from the dead. Lord, you're sitting at the right hand of the Father for them. Help them to realize that that you love them, and that love can heal, that love can save, that love can deliver, that love will answer prayer in the name of Jesus. We thank you. We thank you, Father. Brother Walter.
Father, we thank you. And Lord God, we believe that you are answering prayer. We thank you for the answer. We thank you for healing that one from arthritis. We thank you for healing that knee. Lord God, we thank you for meeting that financial need. And Lord, we send your word to those around the world who are in need of healing from cancer. Be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. We send your word to those that need healing from the effects of the virus. Be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Lungs be made strong and be healed. Heart be healed in Jesus' name. Brain fog leave in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for those pastors in Nepal, those pastors in Cuba, those pastors in Argentina, those pastors in Bolivia, in Mexico, and other parts of the world, in India, that have been affected by this diabolical virus. In the name of Jesus Christ, set them free from the after effects of that virus. Heal them, we pray, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Make their bodies strong and resistant. Oh God, heal them from the tops of their head to the bottom of their feet in Jesus' name. And Lord God, those that have suffered financially, Brother Peter in Nairobi, Kenya, Lord, meet his needs. Restore unto him what was stolen, was taken away by the enemy. Lord God, restore sevenfold unto him and his family. Meet their needs, we pray, as Sister Sheila and her family. And Lord God, others around the world, we may not have mentioned them by name, but in the name of Jesus, we break the cycle of poverty, the curse of poverty. In Jesus' name, be set free right now. Hallelujah. Lord God, there are those who are in depression or in fear. I bind a spirit of depression. I command it to leave you in Jesus' name. I command those suicidal thoughts to leave you in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak health to your mind, health to your body, health to your finances and your family and your family relations in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we bind a spirit of fear that has gripped so many and paralyzed so many around the world. In the name of Jesus, we cast out the spirit of fear. Be loosed, be set free in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Praise God. Brother Tony, we cannot leave this broadcast without giving people the opportunity to receive Jesus as their Savior. Would you do that right now?
The greatest miracle that can happen to you is when you open your heart and life to the Lord Jesus Christ and receive him as your personal Savior. You may believe in God. You may believe in Jesus. But if you've never invited him in, you are missing the whole lot. You are missing everything. So I'm inviting you, along with Brother Walter, we're praying for you to open your heart and receive him and know him as a personal living Savior involved in your life, in your home, in your family, and it can begin right now. I wonder, would you pray this prayer? If you will, Christ will come into your life. Close your eyes, lay your hand on your heart. Pray this prayer. My Father in heaven, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe that Jesus, you died for me, that you rose again, that you sit at the right hand of Father God, making intercession. You shed your blood for the forgiveness of my sins. I open my heart. I know you're knocking at my heart's door. I open my heart. Come in, Lord Jesus. Forgive me. Write my name in your book of life, and with your help, I will live for you from this moment on. But I need your help. Help me, Lord, to live for you, to serve you, to love you with all of my heart. Thank you for what you've done. I confess that Jesus Christ is my Lord. He is Lord of Lords, King of Kings. You are my personal Savior. And I promise, with your help, I will live for you. And if you have prayed that prayer, then let me does what he says he will do. He comes in. Now do three things every day. Talk to God every day by praying. Let God talk to you by listening. What do you listen? Listen to the word, especially the gospel of Saint John. Start with that. Start reading the Bible. It's God's will for you. And third, share the gospel with others. Tell others what Christ has done for you. And if you've been a backslider, you don't have to slide no more. You're going to slide forward. Not only slide forward, you're going to walk forward. And as you walk, you're going to run forward and take up that cross he has for you daily. And you're following the Lord Jesus Christ. Brother Walter.
Praise God. Thank you, Brother Tony, for joining me today on Prayer for America and the Nations. And I want to encourage you, as Brother Tony has mentioned, share this with your friends. Share this on your Facebook page. Share this through Messenger. And remember, subscribe to our YouTube channel. All of these broadcasts are on there. Go to Walter Zygarewicz or Global Vision. We have two channels, and you can find all of these broadcasts also on our website. They get posted on there. On the website, they may not be on immediately, but shortly thereafter. And thank those that have joined us on Facebook Live, on YouTube, as well as on LinkedIn. God richly bless you. Join me tomorrow with Evangelist and Prophet Albert Ramirez. It'll be an hour later with Brother Albert, and we're going to be discussing. Usually we have a prophetic perspective and talk about the authority of the believer with Brother Albert. So join me tomorrow morning. And then on Saturday, we will be back, God permitting, with Brother Tony, Sister Marge, and my wife, Nina. We will be here to at the same time, praying for America, praying for the nations, and praying for you. Remember, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.